Hello guys, how are you? Today is January 19, 2022. And COVID is still rampant in the metro in Metro Manila. That's why my family and I are not really going out that much, no. But we do go out from time to time to buy to do essentials, no. Like paying bills as well, no. Although pwede naman online, kasi hindi ako masyado nagtitiwala kasi with online payments, no, especially with what happened to BDO. Well, in any case, no, I shall be obliging. Today is NBA cards naman tayo ngayon, hindi naman tayo comics, no. Pupunta tayo sa talagang niche ko, which is NBA cards, no. Again, I'll be obliging some of my subscribers' requests, no. Meron kasing nag-request for a 90s player again when I did one for a profile or a spotlight on an NBA player spotlight on Grant Hill, no. Somebody requested for Fernie Hardaway, na gawa na natin, and now somebody is requesting or requested for Jason Kidd, no. Well, yun ang finest RC niya, no. Jason Kidd, no, is an enigma of sorts as well for some collectors, especially those who have collected him over the years, because he is one of those players that were considered to be superstars in the 90s that would be taking over the league. Hill, Hardaway, Shaquille, and him, no, Jason Kidd. Tsaka na sila Garnett, kasi yun yung parang nawala si Jordan for a while, no. For 2 years, although kasama si Garnett sa list, but he was not touted as the best rookie in the 1995 and 1996 draft, no. Hindi siya. Actually, mas maganda pa yung pinakita nila Joe Smith dun, eh, yung number one pick. Well, that's another story for another time. Let's talk about Jason Kidd. Jason Kidd was drafted in 1994, second overall by the Dallas Mavericks, and he won the Rookie of the Year with Grant Hill, no. First overall pick nun was actually Glenn Robinson, si Big Dog Robinson, no. Si Jason Kidd is a touted player coming out of University of California, Berkeley, no. Kaya nga number second pick overall siya, eh. And he joined the Dallas Mavericks, no, and forming the 3Js, no, si Jamal Mashburn at saka si Jim Jackson yung kasama niya. But it didn't really pan out, no, kasi meron natin differences amongst the three. And Jason Kidd at the time was really good, no. Only in terms of passing abilities, hindi siya ganun kagaling sa in terms of scoring. Actually, though I noticed, no, during his early years, Jason Kidd didn't have that shooting touch yet, no. He developed that over time, no. As he was playing overtime, as he was playing over the years, no, habang naglalaro siya, he developed a shooting form and a shooting style. Remember the when he kisses the he makes a flying kiss motion to the rim, no, before taking a free throw. If you remember that, no. Well, no, yung kaya ko sinabing enigma, mayring mystery for other player, for collectors, no. It's because of the fact na hindi ganun kataas ang cards ni Jason Kidd. Hindi sobra. Actually, if you compare it to Grant Hill, magkalapit lang sila ng presyo, eh. Considering the fact that yung longevity in terms of effectivity, mas mahaba yung kay Jason Kidd. Because he played from 1994 to 2013, no. His last stint was with the New York Knicks, no. And Grant Hill never won a championship. Si Jason Kidd won a championship with the Dallas Mavericks in 2011, no, with Dirk Nowitzki. The reason behind that, I'll discuss that, the reason behind why his cards are not that expensive compared to other superstars. May rason dun, eh. May rason dun. Hindi naman talaga sa play niya, but there's a reason behind that, no. Which is something that collectors should also look at from time to time, no. Para alam ninyo rin paano mag-invest isang particular player, no. Currently, he's the head coach of the Dallas Mavericks, no. He's coaching Luka Doncic. But they're successful enough, no. Hindi naman pangit ang pinakikita nila. But still, his cards aren't really that high, no. Even though nakikita pa rin siya sa league. I mean, he's still visible, no. Nandiyan pa rin siya. But yun nga, hindi ganun kataas sa mga cards. Especially his inserts, no. Hindi ganun kataas compared to some of his peers, no, na talagang naging successful like him, or hindi naman masyado naging successful like him, no. Kaso highly collected pa rin si Jason Kidd, just like Anthony Hardaway, Penny Hardaway, and Grant Hill, no. Meron ako mga natagong cards ni Jason Kidd, although kokonti lang, hindi rin ganun kadami because I never really collected him, no. It's just that pag merong available na wala akong magawa sa isang lugar, for example, I mean in Galleria where we hold, well, we were actually holding our meetups there from kailan ba kami nag-start doon, 2001 I think, when Vera Mall, nung nasunog ang Vera Mall when it burned down, no. Everybody transferred to the meeting place every Saturday, transferred to Galleria in 2001 up to the time na nagkaroon ng pandemic, which was what, 2020, no. So it's been 20 years na pumupunta tayo sa Galleria. Well, in any case, yun, no, pag pumunta ako, kung ano-ano mga binibili ko, minsan nakakabili rin ako ng Jason Kidd pag wala akong mabiling ibang players or wala akong napupusuan. I try to buy because I knew for a fact that the cards of Jason Kidd, Grant Hill and Vernie Hardaway and these people, Sean Kemp and stuff like that, are good cards to have, no, for collecting purposes and for, in a way, quote-unquote investment, but hindi naman talaga. It's more of the fact that I really just want to collect a lot of players, no, na different players, no, even though I really collect Tim Duncan per se, no, per se. Well, in any case, no, I shall be discussing again, no, my cards of Jason Kidd, ko konti lang sila, so don't huwag kayo mag-isip na mag-expect na marami, no, just like what happened with what I showed in previous vlogs about with regards to Anthony Hardaway and Grant Hill. Hindi ganun karami mga cards ko ni Jason Kidd, no. Ito yung unang-una natin didiscuss. In any case, no, ang sasabihin ko lang ulit, no, ang pinaka-importante to have for a player collection is his best RC. Kadalasan, pag mura lang kukuha ko, ito nga medyo, ano na eh, discolored na. Ayan, no, para namuti na si Jason Kidd dyan. Dahil yung finest years nito, yung 94-95, medyo nagpe-fade. Nag-green din yung color, no? Siguro something about what they used, no, yung ginamit nilang papel for these kinds of cards, no. Well, again, no, i-discuss ko sa inyo yung mga hawak ko ni Jason Kidd and why his cards aren't that expensive compared to others, no, even though he won a championship kahit na isa lang and he almost won an MVP as well, no, in 2001 I think, no, 2001-2002. No, he almost won. He was the second sa voting. He was the second to Tim Duncan, no? And apparently, talaga maganda yung pinakita niya with the Nets, no? But the thing is, hindi pa rin ganun kataas ang mga cards niya even though his highlights are pretty good, ah? And his assist numbers are really high. He's really a good player, no? He's even part, no? Before I end this, he's even part of the 76 greatest players of all time. Na pinakita itong 75th or Diamond Anniversary ng NBA this year, no, in 2021. So, let's go and let's see my collection, my small collection of cards of Jason Kidd. Let's go. So here they are, no? Discuss natin yung mga cards ni J-Kidd. Si Jason Kidd, who was drafted by the Dallas Mavericks in 1993, no. This is his best rookie card, no. The best base rookie card. It's his finest RC or rookie card, valued today at $15. Mababa na lang, ano. This was highly collected before. Itong card na to, it's a must have for any player collection. That's what I'm trying to tell you kanina, no. Ang isang collection, dapat meron kang best na RC ng player mo, no? For example, you're collecting Zion Williamson, you have to have his Prism RC, yung base. What I'm trying to say is the base, no? Kasi today, yung modern era of collecting, mahirap mangolekta ngayon eh. Kasi ang best rookie card, for example, ni Zion Williamson, is his National Treasures RPA, which would set you back for about, I don't know, noong bumaba na siya ngayon because he's not playing, no? But before about a year ago, millions of dollars ang gagastusin mo for that. So, mahirap makakuha.
So, yung iba, they'll just go with the best base card of any player, no, for a PC player. Ito, ang wala naman RPA or rookie patch autograph si Jason Kidd during that time, no? Hindi naman uso noon. So, ang kinukuha ng mga collectors noon is his best base RC, which is his finest. RC, you should have this, no, if you're collecting Jason Kidd. Also, yung refractor version ito, it's a must-have for collectors. I don't have that because I'm not really a collector of Jason Kidd, no? But for collectors, you need to have that. Muntik na ako manalo before, to be honest. Ang baba lang nag-end. I don't know why I didn't actually try to buy it, no? My other cards, mamaya na yung patch, no? My other cards of Jason Kidd, I'll just show you a few of them. Karamihan dito rookies talaga, no? Actually, halos lahat ito, 90s, except for the patch auto and this auto, no? Ito yung ibang rookie inserts niya na meron ako. This is his, what's this? Upper Deck Premium Collection na parang merong hologram. Ayan. Meron die-cut version yan, which is more expensive than this one. Ayan, Upper Deck. Oh, no. Okay? Premium Collection number 32. Malaki ang ano nito, ang checklist nito. And it's a hard, it's a difficult pull as well. Hindi naman sobrang hirap, but it's the difficult pull. Mababa lang yan. That's not an expensive, ano. Ito naman, Magic's All Rookie from Hoops, no. Ito yung parang chrome version nung insert, no. I also have the Grant Hill here, no, this one. Meron din akong Grant Hill nito. I have a Grant Hill version of this card, which I think I've shown in my Grant Hill blog, no? In my Grant Hill Spotlight blog. Mababa lang din yan. They're not expensive. Both of them are not expensive. Ito yung panyang classic na Dickie Vital's Pity Purse. I don't know what's the meaning of Pity Purse. What is that? Prime Time Players, okay? Ayun, Prime Time Players niya. Parang ang ganda ng mga college cards before, eh, no? Parang merong swirly na thing na makintab, no? It's a pretty awesome card, especially during that time. Isipin niyo, 1993 to. Ayan, he's still wearing the California, his California jersey from the NCAA, no? So, ito, classic to na card. Classic meaning, hindi classic, ha? Classic yung company. So, yun, magandang tingnan, no? Mababa lang din yan. Siguro right now, those cards could be sold for about 300? I'm not sure, 300 up. But na, it won't even reach 500. I don't think so. Ito naman yung premier prospects na rookie card ni Jason Kidd, which is die-cut, no? So, parallel version to. Ayan, D2, kaya die-cut siya. Ayan, no? Meron magandang autograph version to, which is a buyback version from 1997 to 1998. Hindi siya die-cut, kaso ang ganda nun. Kasi this is a rookie card, eh. Nakapirma siya dun. Pretty awesome. I know a friend who has that, no? So, ang isa sa before I forget, no, isa sa mga magagandang that I've seen, no, na collection ni Grant ni Jason Kidd up to now, yung iba kasi nabenta na, eh. Ang nakikita ko magandang may hawak na ganito up to now is si Sol P, no. So shout out to you, bro. I don't think that anyone is still collecting Jason Kidd as voraciously as you are. So ayun, no? Siya yung nakikita ko. Ito naman, rookie card din. Tall boy naman. May ganito rin ako na Grant Hill, eh. Ayan, tall boy na from NBA Jam Sessions. Session, 1994 to 1995. Ayan, hindi pa naka-airbrush pa yung university, university uniform niya, no? Kasi hindi pwede sa, hindi sila licensed by the college, by the NCAA yung time na yan. Ito naman yung Way of the Future na Flair, no? Which is an insert at that time, mahal to before. Kasi ang gandang tingnan, no? Napakagandang tingnan kung titignan ninyo. Ang Flair kasi maganda talagang tingnan ever since. Ito yung Grant Hill na naipakita ko na rin sa inyo. So it's a twinning version in a way. Both are Rookie of the Years. Co-Rookie of the Year sila. Rookies of the Year, no? So, yun. So, Jason Kidd and Grant Hill. Wave of the Future. Right now, mababa na lang yan. They're not expensive anymore. Ito naman yung iba before I go to the autographs, no? Ito yung isa na insert niya, wag to, ito muna. Hoops na ano to, na Skyview, no? Skyview. Ito yung parang ginaya na, ito yung forefathers ng EXL 1996-1997, EX Century. So ito yon, parang dito binase yung set na yon. Ayan o, acetate yung gitna. Which was pretty awesome before, ha? Talagang hinahabol to. I think I have a Jordan like this. No, well, in any case, ito naman, it's not a rookie insert. It's from 1995 to 96. Skybox, no? Skybox to nagaling. Sa hoops pala galing. So, medyo mahirap to makuha. It's a one per, I would assume, no? One per case insert. No? Si Jason Kidd, meron tayo. I don't know how much is that now. But that could be sold for, I would assume, more than 1,000. No, ito naman, premium. From premium, what year is this? Hindi sinabi rito eh. Ano ba nakalagay dito? Medyo malabo. Basta ito, premium to. I think this is from 1996 to 1997. If I'm not mistaken, no? Medyo mahirap to makuha. Ito standouts. Premium standouts ang tawag dito eh. This is a pretty rare insert. Could be 2 per case or so. Noon kasi ganun ang odds eh. 2 per case, 1 per case, 1 per box. Ganun. So, hindi rin siya rookie insert, no? Ayan, yun ang mga cards ko ni Jason Kidd that I could show you. Meron pang iba. I just have to look for them, so wag na lang, no? Ito naman is from his classic autograph yan ni Jason Kidd. Ayan, ang autograph niya. This is number 2,185. So ito, hindi siya rookie auto. That's, yun ang masaklap doon, no? Although he's wearing a California jersey here, no? Yung college nga niya. Kaya ako binili to. I still remember where I bought this. This came from Edsel shop in over at Green Hills in Vera Mall before it burned down, no? Yung shop na yon, yung Vera Mall na yon, no? Binenta to, I think, if I'm not mistaken, I asked him. Sinabi niya, this is being sold by, I mean, Bernie, no? Bernie Aspiren asked him to help him sell this through his store, no? So nakita ko siya, ang baba lang, magkano? 800 ata eh. So sabi ko, ba, mababa yun. But I thought, no, at that time, I thought it was a college rookie auto. Hindi pala. This is his second year, no? 95-96. Yeah, 95-96 na to no lumabas. No, assets, gold assets or assets gold. It should be gold assets, but never mind. So yan, yun ang pirma niya, Jason Kidd. Kaya nagustuhan ko yan because of the fact that he's wearing his college jersey. So hindi ko na siya binenta. So I just held on to it, no? Next up would be his, lagyan na natin dito. So, yung next up would be his authentics. No? Itong authentics autograph niya na to, he's wearing his New Jersey Nets uniform na, no? Number 250. This is just valued at $40. Ngayon, i-discuss natin kung bakit ko sinabing enigma si Jason Kidd. Okay? The reason why I said the enigma siya is because he has all of these accolades except for the MVP award which eluded him, no? So, para naging stigma yon sa kanya na hindi siya nanalo ng MVP. Kaso, napakarami naman players na hindi nag-MVP na mataas ang value ng cards. Ha? Why? It's all about demand. No? People like Jason Kidd. No? There are a lot of collectors who still collect him. But yung demand for his autographs and his cards are not that high. Why? Because napakadami niyang pinirmahan na autograph. So, sobrang dami. I'm telling you. In every year, parang ang dami niyang pinirma, especially for Fleer, no? He even has a lot of autographs for Upper Deck when they release their exquisite line, no? Ang daming pirma doon. Yun, mahal yun, no? Kasi exquisite, eh, no? Lahat naman na exquisite, mahal. So, basically, yan, no? Isipin yung $40 for a Jason Kidd. I mean, kahit nasabihin na natin you could sell that for $3,000, for Jason Kidd, that's still low. Diba? Mababa pa rin siya. His cards like these, no? Itong mga inserts na to are kind of high for set builders. But ang talagang kinukolekta ng mga tao is his autographs. Dahil mababa yung autographs niya, hindi rin mataas minsan yung mga inserts niya. But his parallels are high. because of set builders and yung nostalgia effect ng mga rubies, mga precious metal gems, which I don't have. No, I don't have any of those ganun na Jason Kidd. Yun yun. That's why when you collect, you have to look at a player who likes to sign a lot. If he likes to sign a lot, hindi tataas masyadong cards noon. No? That's the trend. No? Now, maybe some of you would dispute that, but I'm telling you, in over my so many years of collecting, napapansin ko yun. Except for the fact that if a player dies, dadami yung collection, dadami din collector, especially yung nangyari kay Kobe. No? I'll do a player spotlight on Kobe sa second death anniversary niya. No? Showing you that. Kasi pag namatay ang player ng ganun ka grabe, yung nangyari kay Kobe when he passed away, he'll become an icon. No, kasi magiging iconic yung kanyang legacy na iiwan. Maraming magkakaroon ng demand, especially even for those who don't collect basketball cards. So hahanapin yung kanyang autograph. This is kind of expensive, no, for a patch autograph of a legend. Mababa pa rin. This is valued at 100 Beckett. Beckett value nito is just $100. So 5,000. So maybe you could sell this for about 7,500, no? But for a patch auto of a legend, no? Mababa yun for me. This should sell for about siguro 15,000, 12 to 15,000 given the fact that he won a championship in the NBA and he also won a rookie of the year. Yun lang. Ang isa pang rason na nakikita ko kung bakit hindi ganun kataas si Jason Kidd, even if he won a championship. Yeah, well, for one, no, during his stint with the Dallas Mavericks in 2011, when he won the championship with Dirk, no, he was still contributing. Maganda pa rin ang pinapakita niya, but he's not the focal point anymore. It was Dirk Nowitzki. No? Many would argue na bakit sila Garnett noon, hindi naman, mataas pa rin ang card si Garnett. Si Paul Pierce ang focal point, tinulungan lang nila, bakit mataas pa rin ang cards niya? Because Garnett doesn't really sign a lot, no, to be honest with you. Hindi madala maraming pirma si Jason, si Kevin Garnett. Pag maraming pinipirmahan ng player, he signs a lot of autographs, nag-iiba yung demand, bumababa yung demand kasi masyadong madaming choices. So yung ganun minsan it affects the values of the card, no, of the cards of a player, no. Yun yung isa sa mga pwede kong sabihin sa inyo. These cards, no, I bought them low. Okay, ito nabili ko lang to na less than 1,000, although tumaas na rin, alam ko naman natataas siya eh. Kaya sabi ko pataas, ang ibig ko sabihin kasi sa enigma is because bakit pantay lang sila ni G. Grant Hill halos, yun ang enigma doon. Even though he won a lot of championships, he won a championship, si Grant Hill hindi. But in terms of yung ano, yung bibili ka rin, no? Pag bumibili kasi ako, talaga binibili ko lang kung napapansin ko mababa ang benta, no? Na alam ko na legend naman, dapat mataas yun. So, okay na siya magkaroon sa collection. It's an investment of sorts as well, no? Kasi mababa mo nakuha. So, pag tumaas, then well and good. At saka most probably, hindi na siya bababa. Alright? So ito, I bought this for, I think, less than 1,000. Ito naman, I think I bought it for 800 pesos or less than, if I'm not mistaken. To locally, no, sa isang tao who often go to Galleria before. Ngayon hindi na eh, no. I haven't seen him for so long. It's been, if I'm not mistaken, parang ano na rin, decades, one decade most probably, no. Ayan, 0350. So again, no, yan yung mga cards ko ni Jason Kidd na pwede ko ipakita sa inyo. Again, ko konti lang. Sorry for that. Na hindi natin na hindi ko maipapakita sa inyo na kasi dami ng mga Jordans or so. But basically yan yon. Yun ang kwento ni Grant ni Jason Kidd. Jason Kidd, as flashy as he is highly collected, but because of the fact that he has a lot of signed cards, his value has dropped a bit. Hindi naman mababang mababa. It's still a worthy collection to have. For those who want to collect, pwede rin si Jason Kidd. But hindi na masyado sigurong tataas ang cards nito. But at least, no, you're getting a legend of the game, no, na kasama sa mga touted as one of the best players of all time, no? This is a good collection to have if you want to collect Jason Kidd, no? So, nasa sa inyo yun, no? Again, no? Well, in any, so, well, tapos na, no? Tapos na yung vlog natin. Again, for those who haven't subscribed to my vlogs, to my channel, please do so and click the bell button for you to be updated all the time whenever I have new videos, no? So, two thumbs up, guys, no? Thank you very much. Next up, I would assume that I'll be discussing another player spotlight, no? Wag muna siguro sa comic books. Dito muna tayo sa players habang nag-recuperate ang mundo sa COVID, no? But I'll be discussing about comic books from time to time, but not that much, no? Nagkataulan na dalawang sunod. So, yun, no? So, thank you very much for watching and hope to see you again soon for my next vlogs. Thank you very much.